like Tira, like Icha, it's so hard to fight. Yes, because if I lose with Icha, I not winner. Yes.
Kalau misalkan dari saya sendiri tidak setuju.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hai, welcome to Mutiara Podcast. Nah, kali ini Ustazah sudah bersama para juara dari Lomba Rumah Perkalian yang diadakan oleh UNESA. Nah, teman-teman, for your information, lomba ini berskala nasional dan Mutiara Anak Soleh berhasil untuk menyapu bersih semuanya. Kita berhasil untuk menyabet juara 1 sampai dengan juara 3. So without any further ado, langsung aja kita do conversation with all the winners here. Hi my friends, how are you?
I'm good.
Fine.
Okay, maybe Kak Ito first ya. Please introduce yourself to our viewers.
Hello my friend, my name is Anggita Bimanyu. You can call me Ito. I come from 6B class, Abul Wafa. And I'm from SD Kreatif Mutiara Anak Soleh.
Hello everyone, my name is Adira Novaskia. You can call me Dira. I'm from 6B. I'm from SDK Mutiara Anak Soleh.
Halo teman-temanku sekalian, perkenalkan nama aku Afisa Aziza Putri Rawan, aku dari 6C, kalian bisa panggil aku Icha.
Okay, Ustazah want to know ya, how's your feeling after you know your name is the second winner of Lomba Rumah Perkalian yang diadakan oleh UNESA Kanto?
I'm very very happy because I don't expect I the second winner, but I expect is third winner. And I'm very happy.
So you are not confident. In other words, you are not confident. So what about you, Kak Dira? You are the first winner, right?
Right. I'm very happy and proud of myself, and I'm so happy that I could make my parents happy, and then I finally can use my achievement for go into my dream high school.
Wow, sounds good. Kalau Kak Icha, gimana nih Kak Icha perasaannya nih juara ketiga loh, skalanya nasional lagi?
Perasaan saya tentu saja senang karena untuk mendapatkan juara tiga buka ya meskipun apa ya meskipun tidak juara satu atau dua tapi senang banget karena susah gitu harus latihan setiap hari dan moodnya harus dilawan.
Oke, so the first question is Kak Ito, for Kak Ito. Kak Ito, how did you face challenges when participating in this competition?
The challenges is I'm fighting with my NCT and so many rival that very hard to I'm winner, like Tira, like Icha, it's so hard to fight.
But you did it, right?
Right.
Okay. What about you, Dira?
Maybe I will try, and I always want to try to fight with all people. Like it's okay. I didn't think about if he or he is smart or not. But I still want to try, and I don't care if it is win or not.
Oke, okay, Kak Icha, Ustazah mau tahu nih, berapa kali sih Kak Icha itu latihan di sekolah dan apakah Kak Icha memang setelah latihan di sekolah, latihan di rumah juga gimana sih Kak? Boleh dong ceritakan?
Untuk di sekolah terkadang 2 kali sampai 3 kali. Kalau misalkan di rumah aku kadang 5 kali. Kadang di rumah aku melawan sama ayah.
Oke, okay, berlatih dengan ayah nih
yeah.
Di rumah. Oke, okay. Kadira. We know that Ustaz Anikin told me, my friends, that they are preparing this competition around 3 months. Am I right?
Yes.
How did you overcome any stress or anxiety that may have arisen during this competition?
I always like, I'm, I it is. It is depending the condition what I feel. Maybe if I'm still not sleepy, I still want to practice, but practice. And if not, yeah, if still sleepy, yeah, maybe not. If in home, but if in school, I always practice with my friends. Yeah, like that.
Okay, so what about you, Kainta?
I not practice in the home, but I in school always practice with other friend and so many friend that I practice.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Actually, so what is your big motivation, Kak Ito, in your life?
If I win, I can proud of my parent and I can go to school that I want because this LRP. And if I winner, I can use the money for my parent.
Okay. So what about you, Kadira?
Oh yeah, I always want to win. Like, yeah, I always confident of myself, and then practicing, it's make me sometimes if I practice, I always feel so nervous, but I will always try. And then I will always try all playing in board game. And then I never give up and always confident on myself that I can win in this competition. And I proud of myself that I could did it.
Okay. So, what about you, Kaicha?
Motivasi terbesarku yaitu orang tuaku selalu mendukungku meskipun menang atau kalah, mereka menghiraukannya.
Jadi nggak masalah ya kayak gitu ya, menang yeah. atau kalah itu sudah biasa, yang penting yeah. kamu terus berusaha dan berusaha. Could you describe one of the most difficult problem during lomba rumah perkalian, or we call it as LRP?
It's the hard is if there are so many rival, that so many counter for my strategy, and I very hard to choose my best strategy on my LRP competition. That is my opinion.
Okay, so what about you, Kadira?
I think math is easy if you always want to study it, like every day you have to study it, so you can think that mathematics is easy.
Okay, so the key is practice, right? Kalau menurut kakak, setuju tidak sih kalau matematika itu menjadi salah satu materi yang paling sulit yang ada di dunia, kak ya?
Kalau misalkan dari saya sendiri tidak setuju. Kalau misalkan matematika diperpadukan dengan game lain mungkin seru dan lebih mudah.
Jadi matematika dibalut dengan gamifikasi pembelajaran lah ya.
Yeah.
Okay, my friends, Kak Ica, ada nggak sih motivasi dari Kak Ica sendiri sebagai pemenang untuk teman-teman yang belum berkesempatan untuk memenangkan kompetisi ini, dan juga untuk adik-adik nih yang bakal maju ke LRP tahun depan?
Menang kalah adalah urusan belakangan. Yang penting kalian mencoba dulu dan berusaha.
Okay. Kadira, is there any advice for your friends?
You must always feel confidence that you can win, that you can. But if you lose, that's okay. It's a usual thing that you could experience, and you have to confidence and don't think the negative thing, and still think the positive thing, and then you have to try your best. Yeah.
Try your best is the key. What about you guys?
You are so fighting your anxiety and don't think about the lose and the winner.
The last question for all of you guys. For Kaito first, maybe. Kaito, is there something that will you say to your parents and also Ustazah?
Thank you for your support.
Okay. What about you?
Thank you for your support, Sada, and my parents, so I could win this game. And then I'm very happy that you could proud of me. And then thank you for training me, so I can reach my dream. And then I'm very happy of this. And I almost crying. Like, yeah, almost crying.
Almost crying. Okay. I'm so sorry. Kalau menurut Kak Ica, apa sih hal yang mau disampaikan sama mama, sama ayah di rumah, sama saudara juga?
Yang mau saya sampaikan kepada orang tua dan ustada, saya sangat mengucapkan banyak-banyak terima kasih sudah mendukung saya dan membantu saya latihan setiap hari.
Oke. Okay. Nah, ada satu pertanyaan lagi yang ustazah lupa tanyakan. Gak apa-apa ya, ustazah tambah satu lagi pertanyaan boleh ya? Kak Ica, apa sih hal yang tidak terlupakan atau momen yang tidak terlupakan selama LRP ini di UNESA kemarin?
Yang tidak terlupakan yang waktu bawa pengisian pertama, itu lawannya tidak datang, jadi langsung menang.
Oke, okay. It's such a miracle. What about you? Is there any unforgettable moment?
When I get the trophy and then all the gift from when I winning this competition, it's very make me happy, so I never forget it.
Unforgettable. So what about you guys? Is there any unforgettable moments during LRP?
When I'm wanna be winner, I win or no? If I not winner, I will be not winner. if with Ica I'm lost, I'm not winner. That's I very unforgettable.
Oke, okay. Jadi ini judulnya adalah temanku adalah lawan, begitu tak kak itu. Thank you so much for coming to Mutiara Podcast, my friend. And I hope you will get a lot of trophy in the future. Thank you so much.
Yeah, welcome. Yeah.
Oke, okay. Dan jangan lupa like, comment, and subscribe. See you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye-bye.